Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disorder that gradually affects synovial joints, but can also cause extra-articular disease as well. Rheumatoid arthritis has been linked to HLA-DR1 and HLA-DR4. Each time there's a flare, there's an increase in synovial and immune cells, and over time, that results in a thick, swollen synovial membrane with granulation tissue, called a pannus. The pannus can damage cartilage and other soft tissues, and also erode bone. Typically, rheumatoid arthritis affects at least three joints, generally ones in the hands and feet. The disease tends to be symmetric, progressive, and over time, it causes joint deformities like crooked fingers. So, the typical articular manifestations in rheumatoid arthritis are pain, swelling, and loss of mobility in the affected joints, but doesn't usually cause redness or warmth because the inflammatory process is so gradual. Usually, there's morning stiffness that improves after 30 minutes of movement. The most frequent sites of involvement are the proximal interphalangeal joints and metacarpophalangeal joints of the hand, whereas the distal interphalangeal joints are rarely involved because there's very little synovium there. When these joints are affected, however, it typically causes reduced grip strength. In the feet, usually the metatarsophalangeal joints are affected, and it causes a person to bear more weight on the heels and hyperextend the toes. Other joints that can be involved are the wrists, elbows, shoulders, knees, and ankles. Hip involvement usually only happens later in the disease, and that can cause pain in the groin, thigh, or lower back. One very dangerous spot is the C1-C2 joint, which is the only synovial joint in the spine. When that's affected, it can cause neck pain, and if it's not managed properly, it can lead to spinal cord compression and tetraplegia. The system inflammation in rheumatoid arthritis results in cytokines that can cause extra-articular symptoms. For example, cytokines can trigger fever, fatigue, and a loss of appetite that can eventually lead to weight loss. Rheumatoid arthritis can lead to vasculitis, and specifically the formation of atheromatous plaques, which can lead to myocardial infarction and stroke. In fact, cardiovascular disease is the primary cause of mortality associated with rheumatoid arthritis. In skeletal muscle, cytokines cause muscle breakdown, and in the skin, they lead to the formation of rheumatoid nodules over bony prominences. Rheumatoid nodules are round collections of macrophages and lymphocytes that have a central area of necrosis. In the liver, lots of hepcidin is made, and that causes decreased iron absorption in the intestines, and allows iron to get trapped in the macrophages, leading to lower serum iron levels. In the lung, fibroblasts get activated, causing pulmonary fibrosis, and the pleural lining gets inflamed, leading to pleural effusions. Laboratory testing typically includes a complete blood count, which might show anemia of chronic inflammation, thrombocytosis, and a mild leukocytosis. In addition, an ESR and a CRP might be taken since they are markers of systemic inflammation. It's also important to test for autoantibodies like rheumatoid factor and anticyclic citrullinated peptide antibodies, both of which are present in most individuals with rheumatoid arthritis. A minority of individuals may have antinuclear antibodies as well. Bilateral plane radiographs of the hands, wrists, and feet are also important as a baseline for monitoring disease progression. Over time, changes might include decreased bone density around affected joints, soft tissue swelling, narrowing of the joint space, and bone erosions. The diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis can be made if the disease has gone on for at least 6 weeks, involves at least three joints, there's a positive rheumatoid factor or anti-citrullinated peptide antibody, and an elevated CRP or ESR. In some cases, arthrocentesis may be done to evaluate the synovial fluid to make sure there's no evidence of crystals, like in gout or pseudogout, or signs of infection. In 2010, classification criteria were proposed, which established a 10-point scale, where getting at least 6 points out of 10 supported the diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis. The first criterion gives points for either large joint or small joint involvement, whichever gets the higher point amount. Looking at large joints, if at least two large joints from among the shoulders, elbows, hips, knees, and ankles are affected, that gives 1 point. Looking at the small joints, if at least 1 to 3 from among the metacarpophalangeal joints, proximal interphalangeal joints, 2nd through 5th metatarsophalangeal joints, thumb interphalangeal joints, and wrists are affected, that gives 2 points. If 4 to 10 small joints are affected, that gives 3 points. And if more than 10 small joints are affected, that gives 5 points. The second criterion gives points based on the autoantibody levels. If there's a low positive rheumatoid factor, an anti-citrullinated protein antibody, meaning above normal but below 3 times the upper limit of normal, that gives 2 points. If there's a high positive rheumatoid factor, an anti-citrullinated protein antibody, meaning more than 3 times the upper limit of normal, then that gives 3 points. The third criterion involves the ESR or CRP. If either are elevated, that gives 1 point. And finally, the fourth criterion involves the duration of arthritis, giving 1 point if it's lasted over 6 weeks. There's no cure for rheumatoid arthritis, but medications called disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, or DMARDs, which are long-term medications, can minimize symptoms and prevent bone deformity. Most individuals with rheumatic fever are started on non-biological DMARDs like methotrexate. But some individuals, like pregnant women, can't take methotrexate, so they should get another non-biological DMARD, like leflunomide, hydroxychloroquine, or sulfasalazine. And individuals with severe disease get biological DMARDs, also called biologics, all of which suppress some part of the immune system. For example, abatacept suppresses T cells and rituximab suppresses B cells. Some block chemokines. For example, adalimumab, etanercept, and infliximab all inhibit tumor necrosis factor, or TNF. Anakinra blocks interleukin-1, and tocilizumab blocks interleukin-6. Individuals with rheumatoid arthritis should be seen at least every 3 months to monitor the response to therapy, and those who don't respond to initial DMARD therapy should get a combination of DMARDs, such as methotrexate plus either hydroxychloroquine and sulfasalazine, or a TNF inhibitor. In addition to long-term medications, short-term medications like NSAIDs or even glucocorticoids like prednisone can be used to treat an acute flare. Finally, since individuals with rheumatoid arthritis have an increased cardiovascular risk, they should take preventative measures like exercise and smoking cessation, as well as routine use of low doses of aspirin and lipid control with statins. All right, as a quick recap, rheumatoid arthritis causes progressive, symmetric destruction of at least 3 joints, especially in the hands and feet, over more than 6 weeks. But the main mortality comes from cardiovascular disease, especially myocardial infarction and stroke. Diagnosis is generally based on joint involvement, having an elevated rheumatoid factor and anticyclic citrullinated peptide antibodies, and an elevated ESR and CRP. In addition, bilateral plane radiographs of the hands, wrists, and feet are generally obtained during the initial evaluation, primarily as a baseline for monitoring disease progression. The long-term management of rheumatoid arthritis is use of non-biological DMARDs. In addition, severe cases get biological DMARDs. Treatment of acute flares can be done with NSAIDs, while more severe flares might require short-term use of glucocorticoids, like prednisone. In addition, individuals should take preventative measures for cardiovascular disease, like exercise and smoking cessation, as well as routine use of low doses of aspirin and lipid control with statins.